From CBS News, Russ Mitchell, Tracy Smith, and Ira Joe Fisher bring you The Early Show.
It's good to be the boss. Now, you might think one of the job requirements would be good people skills, but that is not always the case, as seen here in the new movie, The Devil Wears Prada, which opened yesterday.
Details of your incompetence do not interest me. Tell some.
In a new movie called The Devil Wears Prada, Meryl Streep plays a magazine editor who is abrasive and abusive. Unfortunately, the character is far too familiar, and many people say they've had first-hand experience working for a boss from hell.
I think there are very much bosses from hell in the workplace. Yeah, I mean, it's an unfortunate thing that they get to the top, but they get there.
My boss had a huge ego. It was like sort of a tyrant, would just huff and puff.
The workplace was awful when you have an abusive boss because just your morale is terrible and you just want to get out of there. You don't want to stay any longer than you have to. It was really bad.
Gary Namie is with the Workplace Bullying and Trauma Institute. No kidding. He has advice for dealing with a ruthless boss. Gary, good morning to you.
Good morning, Russ.
Are there really that many bad bosses out there?
Sure. It's probably about 10% of all bosses.
Yeah.
We know about 1 in 6 workers experience this on a daily basis. You bet. Millions of people.
Now, are we seeing more bad bosses today than we did, say, what, 5, 10 years ago?
Yeah, I think so. I think there's an erosion of union protections. Not that unions prevented bad bosses, but that could back bosses off. And there's just more pressure in the private sector to produce more profit for investors on a quarterly basis. I think people just get crunched more.
In general, why are some bosses so cruel? Is it because he or she can be?
You know, it's the opportunity that's provided. It's a combination of the opportunity. The employer has it set up so that work gets very competitive and cutthroat is the way to be, like the Devil Wears Prada situation, the fashion industry and show business. You guys covered very nicely for yourselves in your denial. I understand that. But the issue then is, but it does take a certain personality to see and seize that opportunity. You got to be Machiavellian. The Meryl Streep character was not psychopathic, but she clearly was Machiavellian, willing to maneuver everybody around to take care of her own needs.
Okay, you've got some advice for us to help people get out of a bad situation when they have a bully for a boss. First up, you say you recommend naming the problem. What do you mean by that?
Well, you're going to reduce the shame if you know that the problem is out there. It's something you can name. If you're sexually harassed, you can say there's a harasser and people kick into gear to respond to it. But when if you don't say you're bullied, if you don't say you've experienced psychological harassment or psychological violence,
okay,
you tend to blame yourself.
You say now that we know what the problem is, you recommend that we take some time off, perhaps.
You got a lot of work to do. This is the point. It snuck up on you, and it's usually your family physician that figured out that the stress is getting to you. Because you're the kind of person, if you're getting bullied, who's got a very strong work ethic, like Andy in the movie, and you're just going to be a workaholic and get through it. You need time to check your physical health. Check for stress-related health impact. Starts with high blood pressure, goes through colitis and a whole bunch of other things.
Oh boy.
Check your mental health. You got to have somebody there to remind you of who you were before and see if you're still in balance. See if there are any laws or policies violated, whether it's state or federal law or the employer policy. And then the main thing to do, and the reason you got to be off work, is I want you to learn to put dollars and cents onto the bully's conduct. There's a mention in the movie that what's-her-name, Miranda, the boss, cost about $300,000 as she arbitrarily changed things.
Right.
Bullies are too expensive to keep. Learn to affix dollars and cents to turnover, absenteeism, and the rest.
Gary, very quickly, you say once you've done all this, it's time to expose the boss for who he or she really is. This is assuming you don't want to work there anymore, correct?
Probably you better have the next job lined up. But you got to go to the highest level. Don't go to the bully's boss. Don't go to human resources. Go very high up and put your financial case, not your emotional case, out.
Gary Namie, are you a good boss?
I'm an excellent boss. Absolutely.
Of course you are.
I am.
Gary Namie, thank you so much. We appreciate
it.
You're watching the Saturday Early Show on CBS.